IVM.
We at IVM love winning massive rewards. And who wouldn't? This IPL season, with the Cred Mega Jackpot Week, by just paying your credit card bill on the app, you can win a Harley Davidson Fatboy bike or 10 years of iPhones for free. What? That's crazy. Cred Mega Jackpot Week from 27th April till 3rd May. Don't miss it. Just download Cred. All right, hello and welcome to another awesome and fun episode of IVM Likes. How do I know it'll be fun this episode? Because of the topic we're talking about, dating apps and online dating in general. I'm sure we have a lot to talk about. Joining me on this episode, I'm Antariksh Thakkar. Joining me is my fellow producer, Jalasmi. Jalasmi, say hi.
Hello, hi.
And our first time on the IVM podcast and IVM Likes version, Anna D'Souza, our communications head. Hi, Anna.
Hi, Antariksh. It's been a long time since somebody's called me a virgin.
Oh, right off the bat, guns are blazing. Anna D'Souza. So cool. Cool. So thank you so much for joining me, guys. Anna has been working at the company for now how long, Anna?
I think 6 months now.
6 months. Wow. And this
well,
is
technically,
coming
I've been working with IVM for like 2 years before that. Just not internally.
Okay, cool. Huh. Okay. That's nice. But so, why is this the first time you've been on IVM Likes? Have I not asked you before?
You asked me many times. I didn't want to do it because just performance pressure.
Okay. Shy is game.
Shy was coming. Okay. But so then you finally heard, we're going to do an episode of IVM Likes on dating apps. And you're like, I need to be on this right now.
Yeah,
this is the episode.
So much dating app material.
Okay, awesome. So that is coming up in the second half of this episode. In the first half, for those of you joining us for the first time, we gave you guys some awesome recommendations of something we have recently checked out or are checking out right now or are watching or reading, anything. So that's coming up in the first half. Let's start that out. Jalasmi, would you like to start us off with your recommendation?
Yes, I have one chota recommendation and one bada recommendation. Okay. The chota recommendation is, if you've seen the movie Piku, there is a very beautiful Sarod theme that plays in the background. Hmm. And 28 minutes of that Sarod theme ka loop is available on YouTube.
I know exactly the theme you're talking about. That is, I love that theme.
Composed by Anupam Roy. It's beautiful. And as a timer, if you just want to like switch off from everything and just listen to that and meditate, I think it is best. The best thing ever.
Do you meditate, Jalasmi?
I do, not with the music, of course. I'm not allowed to. But yeah, kabhi podcast, matlab kaam karte karte laga leti hu kaano mein.
But then, is this music makes you think of meditation? Because that's a very specific reference. Okay, you can listen to this music and meditate.
No, I'm just saying. Okay, let me rephrase. It's meditative.
Matlab,
wo music sunke, isse shant feel hota hai.
Okay, cool. Nice. That's And what is the video called? Sorry, the YouTube link called? Whatever.
It's just seamless 28 minutes Sarod Piku Sarod theme. You can Sarod, just YouTube Piku, Sarod, it. Yeah. You get it quickly. And the bada recommendation is Ajeeb Dastan.
Okay, yes, of course. We just had Kayoze Irani on Cyrus's talking about the movie. And
His story is beautiful, by the way. The story that he directed is beautiful.
Yep.
The one that Konkana and Aditi Sharma, Aditi Rao are
Hayadri.
In, that is also... Yeah. Beautiful. The first two are okay, but thoda mind-boggling hai. So Ajeeb Dastan, the name fits all the four movies. So it's just worth watching.
Okay, cool. Awesome. Okay, that's those are two recommendations. Ajeeb Dastan's can be found on Netflix. It just released, I think, less than 2 weeks back, I want to say.
Yes. Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Okay, awesome. That's Jalasmi's recommendations. Anna, what about you?
You know, I actually can't remember the name of this podcast, but I believe it's something to the effect of British Conspiracy. There's only two episodes out right now, and
how do people find it if you don't remember?
It's on Wondery.
It's on Wondery. Okay.
I'll pull out the name and then maybe we can link it here. They only have two episodes now out now, but it's like. It's talking about people getting poisoned and like high level, like government conspiracies, Russian spy. It's next level nuts.
Like so, I was hooked. If I can kindly ask you to I look up the name right now because we are in the recommendations round.
Okay,
we can't do a recommendation round without the name of what we're recommending. But please talk more about it in the meantime if you'd like.
It's called British Scandal.
British Scandal?
British Scandal.
Candle. Okay.
No, not Candle, Baba. Scandal.
Scandal.
Oh, yeah, that was right the first time. All right.
And basically, it's you know, it's all types of like scandals through the course of history. Lots of them are just, you can relate to them because at the end of the day, it's just all one common human experience. But it's like, who was to blame? Who did what? Did they really do it? How did they do it? It's great, but they only have two episodes out right now that you can hear for free.
Okay. British Scandal.
British Scandal. Yeah.
Okay. It's a podcast. Awesome. Cool. Thank you for that. I would like to recommend a Netflix 3-part documentary.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Fear City, New York versus the Mafia. Okay, this is a story of how New York, back in the 70s and early 80s, the New York Mafia controlled basically all of New York. Like any unions, all unions, like construction unions and all different kinds of labor unions, trash unions were controlled by the Mafia.
Correct.
So if you control these unions, you control basically the entire city. Because so any project which was any like infrastructure project which was more than $2 million in worth had to go through the Mafia and they would get their cut out of it. Okay, so like it was like very well thought out and they had their other side hustles like alcohol sales hota hai, but they had like prostitution and drug rackets and they were running all these other kind of rackets and like hafta vasooli from shopkeepers and stuff, you know, all that stuff for like security.
Correct.
So how do you... So there were like five major families of the Mafia families. They were called the Gambino family, the Lucchese family, then the Genovese, the Bonanos, and the Colombos. They were called the Gambino family, the Lucchese family, then the Genovese, the Bonanos, and the Colombos. Okay, they're like Italian mafia, obviously, so they have Italian names. And so these five families existed, okay, in New York, controlling everything, all the unions, all kinds of projects, all over the place. They had like their cops under their belt, everything. So this documentary tells how much influence the mafia had and how the cops basically caught them. What the cops and the FBI had to do basically was first to like figure out, oh, these guys are the big mafia bosses, which was kind of well known by the FBI already. But then how do you get these guys together? Or how do you get them individually? Or if you can, how do you get them together? Because they made up something called the RICO like way of doing, like the RICO case. Okay, basically, if anyone here has seen the Dark Knight movie, you will remember the RICO case because that's what they use in the Dark Knight the movie to catch all these crime bosses in one fell swoop. The RICO case says that any like multiple individuals, like a whole group of individuals, can be charged with conspiracy of one crime. On one particular charge by this RICO law thingy, like the RICO bill or whatever you call it. Okay. So Rudy Giuliani is right now Trump's personal lawyer. But he at the time was the district attorney of New York. Okay. And he was the one in charge of making a case of all the findings that the FBI had. It was up to him and his team to compile a case together and bring it to the courts and get these guys all on RICO, as the terminology goes. And so this document talks about everything, like how they wired these people's houses, like how they had to. I remember one example was they made one of these bosses, no, the Genovese family boss, they made his TV, like back then cable, right? So they made his TV from the pole or whatever the cable comes from the antenna, yeah. You can just mess up the signal in a way, or the FBI figured out a way to mess up the signal in a way such that it becomes like every few images are static. In the sense that it's irritating enough that if some random person shows up, okay, hey, I'm from this cable company, we are doing like a random check, do you have any problems with the cable? So that's enough of a problem that the person will be like, yeah, come in, just fix my stupid cable. Okay, these guys came in and put like a plug behind the cable and like bugged the house with like the wire. Then so they did this in like in multiple places. They did this in like very commonly the mobsters would use like bars as a meeting point for like their family members, or like where they would like shuffle money from, you know, like something like that. So they got one of these bars also. Then they got one of these mobsters used to talk a lot of business in his car. So they bugged the guy's car, dude. Okay. At one instance, turned out they had bugged the car and something went wrong with the car because the gangster was out of town for like 3-4 days and the bug used up all the car battery. So the mobster didn't realize that, oh shit, this is what has happened. He just calls up his mechanic, right? So the FBI, because the bug, finds out that this guy's called the mechanic. So that night they had to send people to remove the bug because otherwise they would have a whole different scenario of going to these car mechanics, like hoping that they are on the cop side, you know. So they had to like take out the bug. And then once the car came back from the shop, like a week later, they had to figure out how to put the bug back in to the car again. So intense, crazy stuff. Please watch the documentary. It's very interesting. It's only 3-part documentary. It's like about 50 minutes an episode and it's just super entertaining. You'll have a blast. That was a long-winded recommendation, but I guess you guys are excited.
No, it's you guessed that we're excited.
A few families controlling resources.
Yeah.
Bahut familiar lag raha hai mujhe
to. Oldest story in the book.
Yeah.
Yep, correct. Obviously.
Correct.
I mean, there are parallels to be drawn in with politics everywhere. It's just, what it is. Can't be
helped. I didn't say it.
I mean, I didn't say it. I just said politics.
Ajeeb Dastans, which is up on Netflix.
Yep. Anna, what about you?
And I recommended British Scandal, which is on Wondery.com.
All right. And I recommended the 3-part documentary series, Fear City, New York versus the Mafia on Netflix. Please go and check out all our recommendations. Thank you, guys. See you guys in the second half.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to another great week on the IVM Podcast Network. If you're not following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcast on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank the sponsors on the network this week, thewholetruthfoods.com, Seat, PayPal, and Cred. We thank you all for your support. Tune into The Note, where Maruk Inayat talks to Dr. Bipin Joshi about the second wave of COVID. He calls it no less than World War III. On The Habit Coach, Ashton was joined by Yoshita Dave, who's a sex educator and intimacy coach. On Paisa Vaisa, Anupam Gupta was joined by Amit Thakkar and Hiral Jain of Market Pulse Technologies, and they talked about trading in Indian markets. All Things Policy by the Takshashila Institute had on board Mihir Mahajan and Pranay Kothasthane to talk about the recent changes in the Indian intellectual property front. You should definitely check out the Cyrus Says episode with Ace Casting Director Mukesh Chabra. They discussed some of his best work. We also had Ira Mukoti, who has authored various books on history and mythology from a female gaze. The IPL season is in full swing and we have Edges and Sledges in English and Khel Niti in Hindi if you want to check out cricket content. Really, really great conversations on both of those shows. Do check those out. And with that, let's get you back to your show.
All right, welcome back to the second half of this IVM Likes episode. I'm very excited to talk about this because the thing is, we, Jalasmi, Anna and I have only known each other through a computer. We have never met up in real life.
Yes.
So we don't really know that much about each other. So we thought a great way to come to know each other, like know a little bit more about each other, is to just go straight into the intimate details of their dating life. How else should we do this, right?
Of our dating life, Antarik, you have the most number of apps that I've ever heard of one person having on their phone.
I'm going to bear it all, guys.
No, Antarik's dating life is up on Cyrus also.
That is true.
No, but that's only one instance, guys. Come on. You think that's all my dating life
is?
Do you
even have any secrets anymore,
Antarik? Okay, we'll find out on this episode then, I guess. You know what? Why am I building this up? If you guys are not expecting secrets, then I don't have to tell secrets. So that's a good thing. I don't know why I'm putting myself in the corner. But okay, let's just start off from the start. I'm assuming you both either have used or are using currently any dating apps. Are you guys?
Yes, all of the above.
Have used,
I'm currently using.
Oh, that's like the...
I've lost all hope.
Yeah, it's like that's like the Mitch Hedberg drugs joke. He said, I used to do drugs. I still do, but I used to too. That's like Anna, or just Anna said, I'm using dating apps. Okay. I used to do it also. I used to use dating apps. I still do. All right. So, Jalasmi, how long have you been off these apps?
I think it's been 1.5 months now.
Okay. So, just recently. But that was a conscious decision, or you just weren't getting time, or what?
No. Honestly, it was more like, bas ho gaya, bore ho gayi main.
Fair enough. And
plus, you know, the fact that we won't be able to see each other in person for long, I'm not very comfortable.
That's very true. Yeah, that's something that I will get to also, like how COVID has affected all of this for us. But before that, Anna, how long have you been using these apps?
I have been using only one app, Bumble,
for
3 years now, I think, or coming up on four, maybe. And I have had mostly really only good experiences. Like my worst experience is probably awkwardness.
Bless you, Anna.
I mean, like, all the girls. So many girls have terrible stories. And
but is that because you have like a stringent what do you call a screening process or something?
Probably. Like I'm very picky, but I'm assuming everybody is picky, na, about like the people you want to date. So
I mean, so see, I am very rarely picky about a first date. Okay, so firstly, I'll just tell you guys, I've been on the apps for about, I think 4 years, a little more than four years. And I've had like some great experiences, some very weird experiences as well, some downright awful experiences. And but yeah, it's like a pros and cons kind of thing. Like, what are you going to do? As a whole, though, I would say dating apps are a plus, at least for me, because I would never have the kind of like guts to be... just go up to a random girl who I like think is pretty or something, you know, and I just go like spark up a conversation. I could never do that. I'm not that kind of guy. So that way, I think dating apps help a lot. But sorry, Anna, what were we just talking about? I want to say something else. Were you just talking about something?
I was saying that I've had only mostly good experiences on the app.
Huh. Okay. So yeah, because of your screening process, right? So I first date I'll go on with almost very easily with anyone. Like, I'll make a first date happen, like, quite fast.
Girls, you heard it here first. Antariksh is on all the apps. Okay, yeah, and you will date anybody.
Yeah. Anybody. Anybody. You are anyone, yeah. Koi bhi chalega. But second dates are usually, like, so basically, I think what happens for me is that if we are vibing well on just the app, I try to convert her into a first date very often, very soon.
Second date, first date.
Yeah, after chatting, I try to convert her into a first date very soon because I, at least in my experience, have realized that the farther away you get from that first chat, the less interested both of you are.
Yeah, that's like, fair.
That is true. Yeah. I agree.
So if I vibe with someone, I make it into a first date as soon as possible to see if they are vibing more, you know. And if you're not vibing, then why continue?
You're saying the word vibing far too much. Is this how young people talk now? We were vibing.
I mean, vibing is part of my Bumble profile. Not even.
Jalasmi, do you also say this a lot? Okay, do you vibe with people?
I mean, you understand what vibing means.
I know what like, it means. Yeah.
Yeah. It's not a weird phrase. Yeah.
I mean, I understood. I understood. It's just like... We don't use regular things or what? Like, oh, we got on really well.
We got on really well. What are we, 60?
What?
This is start of our dating life, not the end of it. Okay. So let's do something fun to start off this second half of this episode. Can we share what our dating app bios say?
Sure.
Anna, you go first.
I'll go first.
Can also go first. Whatever you want. Okay,
okay, go.
Okay, why did I just... why am I doing this to myself? Okay,
Experience speaks. You are confident about it.
I mean, yeah, fair enough. Chalo, theek hai, thanks. After Jalasmi said that, I'll say what my Tinder profile says. So this is, I'm reading my Bumble profile. My Tinder profile and my Hinge profiles are basically similar to this, the main part. And then Hinge has other questions and Tinder has other questions, you know, all that stuff. Tinder doesn't have any questions actually, but yeah, doesn't matter. Anyway, so I'm Antariksh, 28 years old, comedian, podcast producer, and content writer. I don't know why I said that, content writer.
This is CV's bio, brother. Yeah, this is CV.
Antariksh, some content work coming to you.
No, you have to say that. But you have to say that. You have to say that in the beginning. That's not part of my bio. That's part of like under the name that shows up, right? On Bumble.
No, I think you should keep that for the first conversation.
What are you saying?
What do you do? And then you'll, oh, podcast. Interesting.
Oh, podcast. Oh, okay.
Tell me more about it. You know, that's how you go ahead.
You know, I'm not even kidding. A lot of the people I talk to don't listen to podcasts. It just happens to be the case.
Yeah.
I have to like very often explain what podcasts are. And I'm like, okay, I guess
good,
this is not going to work
your
out.
First conversation. It's a good icebreaker, I feel.
I mean, yeah, fair enough. If they're actually interested, that can be a good icebreaker. Otherwise, you just go with something else. But anyway, so about me, usually a cheerful person, just a Kayute kid. Kayute is spelled as Cayoot. With and then two smileys after that, one regular smiley and one angel smiley, like the halo on top. So right, so usually a cheerful person, just a Kayute kid. I like interesting folks with wacky stories. It goes, stand-up comedian, writer and podcast producer, huge comedy and podcast nerd, obsessed with anything that's funny, looking for chill vibes in these weird times. See, that's a good line. Anna will agree.
No, this is exactly the kind of bio that I swipe left on ASAP.
Okay, then no, I'm safe, I guess.
I just want to tell you, I just want to say, what are you, 16?
Yeah,
what do you mean?
Right?
See, if it works, it works. Okay, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Oh no, he's trying to think like his target audience.
Yes.
Anna, understand.
Oh, you get it. Yeah, smart, there's no shame in trying to get laid with 14 year olds. No, sorry, 18. I meant 18. Sorry, I'm just joking.
This is not. And just please. Anyway,
no, 14 year olds are not allowed on the app.
He was
unfortunately.
Joking,
no, sorry, I'm just joking.
Okay,
I'm just joking.
Yes, you don't know. You don't have any children on the internet. Like,
yeah, I'm sure.
Profiles?
That's true.
Oh, please tell me about
See,
it. Children and their profiles are just hilarious and horrendous. अच्छा है वो filter आता है age filter करने के लिए. Otherwise, I'm like, I am not going only here, Baba.
And then my profile ends with I roll perfect J's 420, and then with like a thumbs up and like a few signs and all that stuff. Okay, wow, that got jealous me excited.
You know, there are a lot of men that have this in their bio.
Man, a lot of women also have this, huh? You don't say that.
Correct, but I'm like.
Yeah.
Why are you bragging about this? You don't know.
Just for
sure
the record, 420 is totally
I
out
said,
of syllabus
not,
for me.
You're not understanding. I roll perfect J's. That is not as common as you think it is. Like people are always like a 420. Yeah, I smoke and all that shit. You know.
You are one of these people. What are you talking about?
It's a great profile. Thanks, guys. I'll take that as a mic. I know, it's cool.
Oh
it's
no,
cool, it's cool.
Vibing also means
you guys can
you
tell
know,
me offline.
Looking for good vibes.
Yeah, no, yeah. A big part of vibing, chill vibes also means you just roll a joint and you're like, just, you know, ha, theek hai, hum dono in Wonderland.
That's exactly what it is. That's the best kind of a dating experience for me is when we are both smoking cigarettes or something else. If you
Everybody's zoned out. I how do you have good conversations when you are zoned out? I mean, I don't know.
I don't know. I've been...
I don't know, man. Stoner lifestyle is not for me.
Okay, all right. Let's get to Anna. I can read my question answers also. If
yes, read,
but
no.
First, let's first get to your bio and then we'll do your questions and answers.
I have not answered any of the questions and answers. I mean, I've not answered any of the
questions.
See,
the advantages of being a woman.
We only get like a very few advantages. So just please let us have these in peace.
Okay, fair enough. No, that's fair. Yeah. So what does your bio say then?
So I have also not said anything about where I work, etc. Because that's just not information I need anybody to have needlessly. But my bio is very short. It says, mildly okay. Irreverent feminist that likes breakfast dates, eating, reading, and working out hard enough to be able to eat all the things. P.S. Will watch your pets for free. That's it.
And tries to keep her plants alive.
Okay. That's it. But I will say this, that I have put strategically attractive pictures of me on the app. One is in like in some like nice greenery area. One is in sari because, you know, we are sanskari also.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. One is in an art museum because I am a person of culture. Okay. One is with a dog, and then of course one bikini photo has to be if you want to get matches.
Hey, cool. No, that's not true.
Makes it easier.
Okay, that's fair. That's totally fair. Of course it is. Yeah. So I have like a pictures wise, I have like put pictures of me. This one of me doing
in a bikini.
Yeah. See, I have to root for matches, man. What are you gonna do? I have one with a dog as well. I want one with a cat also, cat and dog. I'm like, don't
make
her. Why not? And then one in like a glove, in like one of the surgical gloves, saying, guys, that's how I'll keep myself, whatever, you know,
safe
that's a social distancing. Yeah.
Safe in these times.
And then one and then one cute pic in an apron about to cook. So I'm like, this covering all bases, you know. You never know what the other person is looking for. I should have done a guitar also. Okay, and now I know. I'll do a guitar.
No, guitars are out. Nobody wants to listen to anybody play Wonderwall at a party. Please, nobody cares.
That is the most common song. That is true.
Yeah.
Okay, so Jalasi, what about you? Do you remember
what your profile is? Thanks for busting that myth, Anna. Wonderwall common ho gaya. I thought when my ex played it for me, he's like, you know, this is such a beautiful song.
No, I don't listen to English songs. This is why he's your ex now, Jalasi.
Damn. Yeah. I'm heartbroken.
Because he's singing Wonderwall for someone else, because that's the only song he knows.
Theek hai yaar, uska loss.
Okay.
Jalasi, you guys should start dating consultancies. Itna sara strategy into, you know, making like a nice dating profile. Like, Anna, please, I'm coming to consult you.
Hey, you come. I don't want to consult with men, because lots of these men, I think, actually do this apparently, and it's some full on catfishing happening. But yes, I'm always happy to help a sister Jalasmi anytime.
So yeah, that actually, I know you're right, huh? That actually is a thing. I know of a very good friend of mine. Fuck it, I'll say his name. You know Shreyas Manohar, right? He's been on Cyrus Says Quite a lot.
Yes.
He's been on podcast. He has written, so he's a freelance writer, and he has written for these Tinder profiles. Like, one of these dating apps contacted him, I think it was Tinder only, and saying, okay, we have all these profiles and all these people need someone else to write their profile. So there's like a system. There's like a system that they come up with.
Wow.
Come up with to make an interesting profile. Okay?
Dating profile like, ka bhi career ho raha hai yaha pe.
Yeah, dude. This guy's written, dude, and he's earned decent money writing these profiles for other people. Like there's a system. They're like, you have to, they'll give him the job, they'll give him the hobbies and all that. And then He'll make like one or two iterations of it, and they'll choose one of them and then they'll go with it. And so I asked him, like, what if it doesn't work? How do you know if you're successful? Like, I got my money, what I care. But yeah, this is actually a thing that people do.
Now we know, do not trust anybody from their bio.
Yeah. So again, that's another question. What is more important to you guys? The picture, a good picture or a good bio? Or
bio.
Both of them combined?
Bio.
Combined. Bio also matters. It's like your bio, kaise likhte ho na, wo tumhari personality thodi bahut batata hai. Aisa mujhe lagta hai. That's what I feel. But
so, do you get turned off then if someone doesn't have a bio?
100%.
I get really turned off if someone has only one picture. That's like, dude, come on, that's bullshit, man. Don't.
And also people who are wearing shades in all of their pictures. Like, who are you? Men in Black. What's happening?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I think eyes dikhni chahiye. Eyes are sometimes
windows to the soul.
Windows to the soul. Aankhe achhi hoti hai to aur attraction hota hai actually.
Really? I feel like I don't care how anybody looks. I'll date anybody. But you must be smart and like funny.
Some people have really pretty eyes.
Right. Yeah, some people do.
Jalasmi, you have not read out your bio.
I will. Okay.
Chalo, let's go.
Okay, so I try to be very cute. And please, I am putting myself out here, being very vulnerable. But maine kya likha hai? I have second thoughts about this now. But pushes pull and pulls push. Still unsure of left and right. Calls 1:30 saade ek and 2:30 saade do instead of ded and dhai. Always excited about Christmas. That is my bio.
Yeah, that is
cute.
Very cute.
It's cute.
Yeah.
Yes, maybe a little bit like something also real other than just this.
Yeah, I am just very goofy that way. So, bas usko maine likh diya. And
I would swipe right on you, Jalasmi, on this bio.
Oh, thank you.
So, listeners, if you want to rate our bios, please let us know in the comments. I know I'm winning this, guys. Come on. It's just no competition.
I think it's very important, Antariksh, that somewhere you upload that what you claim is the cute picture of you in an apron.
I'll show it to you guys.
No, I like.
I have uploaded it. It's on Instagram. It's one of my Instagram.
Oh.
My life is an open book, man. I don't hide shit.
What did you say? You could cook rajma, no?
No, I can make a lot of cool shit. I can follow the recipe for anything now. I can make rajma. I'm sure it'll come out at least averagely fine. Like, you'll be able to have a decent meal. But I can make a killer pizza from scratch, like with the base, with the sauce and all. I can make shahi paneer. I can make a mutton galauti kebab, which is so good.
That is impressive.
Yeah. So I do come fancy shit, man. I can make I don't say this lightly, a killer grilled sandwich, like the works.
Okay, no, you know what? I actually pride myself on my own grilled sandwich. So we should have a grill off at some point.
Hey, that'd be awesome.
Wow, do that in office, please.
Yeah, in office. We can just bring a grilling machine to office and we'll do this.
Okay, yeah, let's on, man. You are on, like down kakaong.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Awesome. What are your most preferred apps? You said Bumble, Anna. What about you, Jalasmi?
Only Bumble. Hinge didn't really work for me. I don't know why. I also feel like people on Hinge were kind of looking for something a bit more serious than I've been looking for.
Okay.
I found conversations on Hinge kind of awkward somehow. I don't know why. Maybe Bumble's colors are brighter.
That's definitely true, man. Hinge colors are very depressing, dude. Very low energy. I agree.
You're on all five apps, so what do you prefer?
So I have used all these apps at different points, but right now on my phone I have only Tinder, Bumble and Hinge. But I've used OkCupid, I've used Truly Madly, I've used Happn, and you know, whatever. Happn is the one where you only get matched if you have physically crossed each other's path at some point.
Correct, which is an interesting thing.
How do they figure that out?
Just geolocation.
Geolocation is on all our phones.
Yep.
Ooh, so COVID pe kaise kiya hoga unhone?
Yeah, I guess no matches during COVID. Ooh. Sorry. you're right, dude. That app must have gone broke.
Yeah.
I don't know what's happening with Happn. What's happening with Happn? Nice. All right. Three, Tinder, Bumble, Hinge, we've all used those, right?
No, I have used mainly only Bumble. Tinder and Hinge, I downloaded for 15 minutes. Then I'm like, nahi bas, yahan pe mera kuch nahi hone wala. Plus, I have that thing that Tinder is mainly only for hookups. While Bumble, you can take it slow, you know, try dating, have friendships and stuff like that.
So, I feel that all these apps are whatever you want to make out of it. Like, because I've like done everything from all of these apps. You know what I mean? Like, I've like dated people from Tinder. I've hooked up with people on Bumble and it can go anywhere. You know, there's no real rule.
You're a career dater at this point.
Dude, I'm literally saying I have gone on so many dates and I'm always talking to so many people at one point. I often, you know how they'll just give like the first letter of your name. Right?
Yeah.
Like for women, right? Very often they give the first letter. I forget what their name is even after they've told me. Because I just talk to so many people. This is what it is. And then I have to I'll ask them again, hey, what's your name? I can't believe I haven't asked you your name yet. And she'll be like, you did. My name is this. I told you. That has happened.
And then do they continue talking to you?
I mean, depends on how charming I am in that moment, you know. Sometimes it'll be fine. Sometimes, sorry, boss. That was the only reply after that.
And modest in your bio. Modesty is very modest. High.
Okay, cool, cool. You're joking. Okay, cool.
No, yes, that's sarcasm.
Okay, cool.
Jealous me, you?
I mean, in what sense? In the kind of apps I use?
Sorry, I forgot the question only.
Oh, I forgot the question also, man.
You were talking, you know, so I was saying mainly because I think it's also the way they've branded Tinder and Bumble differently. Bumble just feels like a more secure platform at this point. Although the fact that you have to make the first conversation is a little tedious because I'm not very comfortable as a stranger says, say hi, hello, kar do. And usually you run out of pickup lines and, you know, you're like, just hi, good morning. How are you doing? That is that is left.
We will chat after this. One crash
or
course.
Maybe I just look at their bio and if they're talking about something that interests me, then I just take some news or some topic and I'm like, achha, iske baare mein suna hai kya tumne?
Yeah.
I mean, that's the best I can do.
I try to do is, again, depends on what the starting line is. If it's going well, if it started off well enough, very often I'll make a game out of trying to guess what their name is. Because dude, the chances of getting it right are very slim. Right?
Wow.
Chances of getting it right are very slim. So just make a game out of it, become something fun you can do, you know, why not? I also make a game out of guessing, like if sometimes it says like, you know, like 11 kilometers away. So I'm like, hey, I'll make a game. I'll guess in three tries. And if I guess it right, you meet me for a date. And this has worked multiple times.
Bacha hai, bacha.
Yeah. Aashiq hoon main. Okay. Okay, what else I wanted to ask is, yeah, how has pandemic coming to the pandemic now? How has this affected your online dating? Okay, but no, before that, how often were you guys meeting people through these apps?
I met only one date, one Bumble date I've been on so far.
One Bumble date?
Yeah, and only once.
How long did you use the apps for though?
So I've been using it on and off. And because yeah. When I went to my favorite city, Bangalore, I'm like, yahan ke bando ko to dating pe dekhna hi padega. Although most of them were like entrepreneurs. I have my own company, mera khud ka business hai and stuff like that. There was
That's
one
a good
guy.
Thing. You don't say it like yeah. a bad thing. That's a good
no,
thing.
No, no. They showed off in a very weird way. And
oh,
like,
okay.
I mean, theek hi
hai. It's like in Delhi, they say, jante mera baap kaun hai. Bangalore, jante mera business kya
hai. Exactly. All startup people. No, all very, very intellectual people. Sometimes you are like, ab mujhe thoda complex feel ho raha hai types. But then this guy I found, I had a 2-week deadline. I went only for 2 weeks to Bangalore. And this guy was a musician and stuff like that. And I really liked his bio. We started talking and stuff like that. And end mein he's like, achha, ab tu ja rahi hai, toh I'll come to meet you. I was actually like, that was my test. Ye milne aega, so that is the best thing. Ye milne nahi aega, toh I might just stop talking. Wow. But effort toh karna padta hai na.
Nahin, jealous me. I feel like you have to make some more effort.
I was there for 2 weeks. Mere liye wahan tak jana, to travel in Bangalore city till there was one big effort.
But you didn't go for him. You were there because he was there.
I went. He didn't. I mean, thoda main gayi, thoda wo aaya. And then, but that was the first date. And I'm very happy. It was a very good date. I mean, there was not much to talk because I'm also usually awkward. Abhi jaise baat kari ho, aise sabke samne baat nahi hoti. But then, you know, topic pe topic nikla and it was like a very calm, chill date. We vibed. I'm happy I met him. Now he's a good friend.
What did you guys do on that date?
Not like
what you did like after going home or something. I'm asking like, went 2 hours for dinner, you went like, watched a movie.
Yeah. We sat in a cafe for the entire day and hopefully wahan ka internet chal nahi raha tha. It was a work day. I finished my work and I'm like, chalo, aaj kaam khatam, extra kaam nahi karna hai, jaane do. And yeah, we were talking.
You met him while you were on work. You're on call at work.
Yeah, I told him apna laptop leke aungi because it's a work day. And
dude, he did not have a good date.
Yeah, he did not have a good date.
No, I switched it off after that. I can't help it, yaar. If you have work, it's a working day. You can't take chutti. What
That's
to do?
That's true. That's very... Oh, okay. So, okay, now I get it. He asked to meet and you were like, hey, this is what I'll have to do. If I want to meet you, but I'll have to get my laptop to work as well. And he was like, okay, fine. Is that what happened?
Yeah, but hopefully us cafe ka internet nahi chala. So, I didn't work.
Hey, maybe he planned that.
Wow. That's why you didn't work, then that doesn't count.
Yeah, he cut the internet lines and all of that.
No, he's a very sweet boy. He wouldn't do that. He wouldn't harm that way.
The internet. He wouldn't harm the
internet. Yeah, he wouldn't harm. No, I was going to say ki wo aise kuch nahi karega. Like, he's a very sweet boy.
Okay, cool. Nice.
How old are you, Jalasmi?
I'm 25.
Okay, cool.
TKR hota, I'm also learning. That was the first time I took the courage to go. And mainly because, I mean, looking at him, I also felt like I could trust him. Plus Bangalore tha, toh I'm like, haan, theek hai, yahan pe kaun hai judge karne wala, chalo jaate hai. But I'm glad I went. So yeah.
Good. But it's also great that your first experience on the app was a positive one.
Yeah, for sure. That makes yeah.
Definitely.
Cool. Yeah.
But was it so positive that you're like, nothing will top this. That's why I'm never gonna go on a date again.
I didn't go anywhere and I've deleted the app. So I don't know if I will log in again, but maybe later, some other time.
Okay. Abhi to nahi. What about you, Anna? How
a foolproof step-wise system, Jalasmi.
Okay.
It cuts your time by half at least.
But yaar, Bombay boys, I'm not really very...
No, but Bombay has boys from everywhere. No, there are so many Bangalore boys in Bombay. So many Delhi boys. So many people from everywhere.
That's okay. But it's just, I just have this thing in my mind that, you know, Bombay guys, maybe.
In fact, now half of Bombay has moved to Bangalore. So you'll likely find Bombay boys in Bangalore.
Ayo, no. May that never happen.
What about you though, Anna? How often were you Were you like going on dates or something?
I was going quite often on dates, but I would always limit it to like 3 kilometers within like a 3 kilometer radius of where I live. So a coffee shop down my house.
Like the setting, the filter settings on your app.
Always, yeah.
3 kilometers. 3 kilometers is very, it's very choosy though.
Very,
because
very.
I have like 10 kilometers because that's like a kind of a general.
No. My dating location radius was larger. I was like, I would only meet them 5 minutes away from my house.
Oh.
We will meet for coffee so that if this is going badly, I can just leave and come back home and enjoy the rest of my day or evening or whatever.
Okay, that's fair. Yeah. That's fair.
And always coffee, because you can finish a coffee in 10 minutes or coffee can go on for longer time also.
But did that happen often, that you had to leave midway? This is going terribly.
No, actually. The first date that I ever went on, I went on a breakfast date because I was scared about people having expectations that you go for dinner and all. So it's like breakfast is the safest meal of the day. And that was it is still my best Bumble date. He was so nice. We went on like more dates, etc. And now we're friends and we're in touch. He's not living here in this country currently. But it was great. Like, he's smart. He was so much smarter than me. Hmm. Which I don't know why. Like, I love to feel dumb around people, but somehow it's very attractive when someone's smarter than you. And kinder than me, more politically correct than me. Just like, I was like, wow.
Okay, fair enough. Do you guys have like a favorite place to either arrange to meet or my first suggestion for a fun date is always, let's go bowling, because there's a place where you can bowl and drink, so you can get drunk while bowling, and it's only fun if both of you are terrible at bowling. So I suck at bowling, so I'm hoping the other person does as well. And if you suck at bowling, then it's damn fun. If one of you is good, then it becomes like, oh yeah, I'm just good and all, and you suck and whatever, you know.
But this is your first date?
Yeah, first date.
That's a lot of time. Like, what if the person is a complete ass? You can't cut the date.
I mean,
short.
So again, like, so we have already been vibing on the internet, right? As I said, try to make it into a first date as soon as possible. So this is like a first, like a cool, fun idea, other than just the regular dinner and drinks, or the like a movie date is never fun because you don't talk only.
The other place that is a good place that I like to go for dates is the plant shop. Because I anyway want to go look around, maybe buy a plant. I'm friends with the plant shop auntie. Hmm. So I'm like, you want to come just like run an errand with me? I don't really have a lot of time. And and then if I'm happy with them at the plant shop, then we'll go for coffee also.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Nice. What about some, I completely skipped that point. What about the pandemic? How did it affect your dating life? Like, Jalasmi has been off the app, I guess, so.
Yeah, but I'm friends with all my, the guys I connected with on Bumble.
All her
matches. So I'm talking to them anyway.
Oh,
she's curating a little harem of her own.
And you actually just stopped using the app like a month and a half back. So you did use it during the pandemic quite a lot, right?
I used it for some time.
Yep. Did firstly your usage increase or decrease during the pandemic?
No, not really. अरे काम इतना होता है कहाँ तुम बम्बल लेके बैठोगे. But yeah, I mean, I did spend some time, good time, trying to search for companions with whom I can talk and chill.
Yep.
ठीक है.
What about you, Anna?
I tried like swiping, but I feel like so many more people came on the apps, and so the quality was really diluted. I hate to say this, people are not objects, then we must not judge them like
that's
this.
The point of dating apps though, man.
That's also true. It's, like, if I'm judging them.
Like, it's all about options. So many people have so many options.
But like, I just wasn't into anybody, like, except, and then even when I matched with somebody, like, I was like, maybe it's just pandemic fatigue, but I was like, do I have the energy?
Yeah. Like, initially when the lockdowns and all happened, like, I remember, one or two months in, I forgot how to chat with people, because the first conversation would be like, dude, this is a pandemic, right? Just stuck at home. And then where do you go from there? With this all, everyone's agreeing with everyone, okay, this sucks. This is terrible. My parents are super paranoid, you know, all that same thing, everything that everyone's talking about.
Either that or you're planning future dates. Ki haan, hum yahan milenge, yahan jayenge,
those two is terrible. Never do that, because future dates, to matlab, you're never going to meet. Okay? It just doesn't happen.
So I actually have an interesting story about, so at the beginning, very beginning of lockdown, like first few days only, I matched with this really like cute fellow. Okay, very cute. Seemed smart also. Just like straight first minute only of conversation was just jokes. Nobody asked anything, anybody about like, what do you do? Whatever. Yeah. We were just like joking about something. There was some talk about a mandolin and I was like the instrument or like the thing to cut vegetables with. So it was just, it was going great. And then we started doing video dates and like for a few months, we were talking, we were hitting it off. Nobody was leaving the house and he anyway had like some sort of,
injury.
Autoimmune condition, and so it was risky for him. So, and anyway, whatever, like we were just like nobody will go anywhere. And then finally, like, then we had some sort of disagreement about some like political thing. Okay, so then we didn't talk for like a month. Then we started talking again. Did that. When the lockdown eased, like a few months later, I was like, chalo, let's like we'll meet. So he said, cool. I was like, come to the plant shop with me. We went to the plant shop, he also needed plants.
No, did he think, wow, is this a punishment for having a different political opinion than you? Take him to the plants.
No, he was into plants also.
Oh, really?
Like he was into plants and he was like, cool. He was so happy that I took him to this lady who was solving all his plant problems, etc.
That's nice. Wow.
It was a great date. We met another friend of mine on this date, who was also at the plant shop. And so I was like, chalo, let's all three go for coffee. So she went ahead and I was like, we'll take another rickshaw and go. We're going in and suddenly he's like, so did I tell you that I'm moving back in with this girl? I was like, yeah.
Huh?
Yeah, I was like, she was like, yeah. Dude. And this is his ex that he had told me about. He's like, whatever. I was like, so then why are we on a date? He's like, this is not a date.
Dude, that is the worst, you know, that has happened. And it is so infuriating when that happens. Because you're like, dude, how did you not know this is a date? It's ridiculous to imagine. How did you not tell me? Yeah, exactly. We met on a dating app. We've been talking. And you obviously, either we both have been flirting with each other or you've been putting up vibes. Again, that term. But
vibe.
But you, yeah, how are you, how is this not a date? If it's not a date, you have to tell me explicitly.
But wait, this is not a fucking date. Punchline, Antariksh.
Okay,
so we go for coffee and my friend is also there. And then while he goes ahead and my friend and I are entering the coffee shop and she's like, you know, I was like, dude, you know what? This guy just told me like he's moving with his girlfriend and like this is not a date. He was like, oh my God, 3 years ago, the exact same situation happened to X, which is another friend of ours. He met her on Tinder. Then also he was like, we should just be friends.
Okay.
And now he's friends with all of us. He's a great guy. But
okay. Wow, what a weird guy.
I don't know.
Did he move back in?
Confusing situation.
Did he actually move back in with his girl?
Yeah.
Okay. And that's fair. What are you going to do?
She's nice and like they seem happy. Yeah.
Yeah, that's fair. Cool. Fair enough. Okay, we should be wrapping this up. We've gone on long enough.
But have you ever had a complex? Yaar, itne good looking Oxford, Harvard wale bante hain.
Okay, I have a great.
I always get that.
That happens to me all the time. Okay, I actually used to do this part thing as a joke. I'm gonna say right now. I should do this bit as a joke, okay? Because this is an actual true thing that happened to me. I once was in Goa, okay, and I was using Tinder, and I matched with like this gorgeous girl in Goa, okay. And in my mind, I'm thinking, dude, I'm in Goa, man. I'm gonna get laid, right? Because that's what I'm thinking when you're in Goa, that you're gonna get action. It's just what it is. It's a thing. You guys know this. Well, I'm not making that up, right? You guys know this.
No, we don't know this.
I obviously don't know, but okay.
What are you saying? Goa, like, they call it like, dude, well, why do like Paltans
of
guys?
You go to Goa with?
What?
No, you go to Goa with.
No, I've heard this from friends. Yeah, I've never been to Goa, but I've heard this from friends.
Yeah.
No, you know, my Goa trips are not like just living on the beach in shacks. I'm just with like friends who live in Goa only, so.
Yeah, same with me, but dude. I'm still a normal human being. Okay. This is not.
Okay, so go on.
Okay, anyway. So I'm asking like this gorgeous girl and I'm thinking, oh, this is great. I will have a good time, whatever. I have someone to meet in Goa. This is fun. And I sent, like at the time, I used to have like three opening lines that I would send to every single girl. Because I was like, oh, this works. So I'm going to use the same lines every single time. Okay, because it did work at the time. So I remember kind of something along, I'm going to paraphrase, but something along like, hey, hi, wow, you're so pretty. Thanks for the like, too kind. And then I would say something like, I'm terrible at first impressions or something like that. And like, hoping to talk to you or something like that, whatever. Okay. And thinking like, And I signed out of my Tinder thinking she'll reply if she wants to reply, right? Like if she sees this, she's also in Goa, probably on a vacation as well. If she wants to reply, she'll reply. She replies back within a minute, okay? Which usually is not often how dating apps, at least in my experience, work. Like normally you take a little more time to reply, at least initially, right? She replies back within a minute. I'm like, oh, this woman is excited, dude. This is great. She actually wants to meet her, want to hang out. It's great. And I swear to God, I went on my Tinder. This is what she said. She said, sorry, I'm new on Tinder. I meant to swipe left. can you teach me how to unmatch? No, that last part didn't happen. But it would have. No, it would have been hilarious.
That's amazing.
Yeah, but that actually happened. That's crazy. Another time, I remember once I had like told a girl that, we were like vibing really well. I'm like cracking great jokes, and she just every reply of hers like ha, like just laughing back, like, so I'm killing it. It's great. And I tell her, hey, I'm doing a comedy show today evening with all these comedians, whatever. Like, I'm doing this comedy show today evening. Do you want to attend? And she goes, yeah, great, dude, I'll be there. Awesome. And then I go, hey, awesome. Tickets are like on Bookmash for $200. You can buy them. And she just never replied, dude. Hey, what? You want a free show also? What is this? No, I'm just joking. That's terrible. That's stupid of me. I don't know why I did that. But it has happened.
When you're talking about dating, I have an example. I was watching 36 Chinatown that day. Mm-hmm. Don't be like the Upen Patel character. That is something.
I've seen the movie, but I don't remember what exactly the quotes
are.
He
is in this big casino, okay? And he'll just go around looking for lonely women. He'll be like, you know, pitching himself to them like a rose key, you know, scheme.
This is
you get to spend some time with me and stuff like that. And I'm like, kaha se? I mean, no wonder it's a 2006 old movie. But yeah.
Fair enough. Okay, I'll try not to be Upen Patel.
I meant to swipe left. Wow. Yeah.
That's so. Another time I remember the first thing a girl matches with me, and the first thing she says, I think it was Hinge, so I must have said hi. And the first thing she said, instead of a hi back, she goes, you know, you'll be really good looking if you lost weight, right?
Oh my like, God, wow. That is
to hell with such people. Like, wow, to hell.
Dude. I don't even know you. You didn't say hi. This is terrible, dude.
And then
I said something like snarky back or something. And she like, oh wow, you got offended. I thought a comedian can take a joke. I'm like, no, dude, that's not a joke.
This is not about taking a joke. This is not a joke. It's like about being an asshole.
Hey, tell me what snarky thing did you say? Because I get this. I mean, tumko to app pe bola, mereko to muh pe bolte. What do you say to such people?
If they're saying it to you in front of you, just kick them in the balls and walk away.
I forgot what it was. This was a while back, but it did happen. The worst opening lines that I've gotten, I mean, opening lines are difficult for sure. I wouldn't hold it against anyone. But a very bad one that I hate getting is, I hope you're funny. Or, you know, something along the lines of, oh, if I say something like, oh, I thought you would be funnier. That's one of the worst, dude. Because, dude, it's not a comedy show. You come to a comedy show and then tell me I'm not funny. Don't tell me that.
You don't realize what you'll have to like write things for months. No.
People think it just comes. Yeah, exactly. And not, dude. And also, like, if in regular conversation it's easier to be funny, then, like, you know, opening line has to be funny. It's not easy, dude.
I mean, in a conversation, at best, you're aiming to be a little bit witty. Like, you're not to, like, have
like,
somebody.
Do a bit. Yeah, exactly. Very true. Any other experiences that you guys would like to share before we wrap this up?
I just want to say the entire, I mean, maximum people on all these apps are either trekking people, fitness wale hote hai, body banane wale. I mean, why is everybody following the same bandwagon of, you know, everybody's putting trekking pictures and everybody's putting fitness pictures.
I think
it feels quite really fake sometimes. I mean, if you're putting yourself out there, might as well be genuine.
It's because hashtag self-love is trending. That can be the only possible reason.
You know, like all that stuff. I think people think that people want to see them at the gym and getting fit. So people put those pictures. It's the same reason why I put something of me cooking, you know, because I feel like, oh, someone would be interested in that. And that's why I put it. But you... Or Anna or I may not be interested in that, but I'm sure there are enough people interested in that. And yeah.
No, I'm not uninterested in people who go to the gym and are fit. At one point, I also did these things. So I appreciate this. But like, there are times when like, why are you shirtless in the mirror in the gym instead of like working out?
I get.
Like, what is this?
No, that's not just that. every second person is putting out such pictures. So, you know, sometimes it just feels like everybody looks the same. Everybody is the same. And then you are like, what is even the point?
Yeah, that's fair.
That's fair. That I agree with. So does it get tiring though? Like at this point, right now, I'll be honest. At one point I was using dating apps like a lot. When I would like get up in the morning, I would like be on the commode and I'd be swiping. Before sleeping, I'd be swiping.
Such an unattractive picture.
Yeah, but you get it.
If you are matching with Anthony,
see.
For sure, dude.
That used to be something I used to say on stage. That guy. So, ladies, if you ever match with me, you know where I was and I swiped you right. Taking a shit, dropping bricks. So basically what I'm saying is I was using it all the time. Any free time that I had, I would just start swiping just instinctively without even thinking. And I had like 3 apps, so it would take me a while also to get done. So I got really tired of it and like got really like depressing and really, really sad. So I like right now I've like waned off. I'm almost not using Hinge and Tinder almost at all. And
Almost not using.
Like basically like Tinder today for the research for this episode. Because I want to read my profile. Like I forgot what it said on Tinder. So I just opened it up and I ended up swiping like 10 people because I opened it the app and what do you gotta do? But that's about it. I'm using only Bumble right now. And that too, like I'll open it like once in like 3-4 days, 5 days. So I think I'm at a good place with it right now.
I feel like you need to go on a tolerance break from the dating apps.
Like we all or me in person?
No, you. Me? Tolerance.
I'll just wait for a nice new wave of hope to come to me.
Not saying new wave. These two words we don't want in the current pandemic. No more waves.
Wave of hope. That's what I said. Yeah, you know, ghar pe jaise. I want to say this. Sometimes what happens is my parents are outside and they are like looking at matrimony sites for profiles for me. And you're inside, I'm swiping on Bumble. And I'm like, e kya ho raha hai? What the hell is happening?
That's so funny. Any other like closing points? You want to just say someone, if someone looking to get into dating apps or is struggling with dating apps or is struggling with dating lives, their dating life in general. Anything like during this time, it's been hard for everyone. It gets really lonely. What should people like that?
The dating apps have these interesting features. At least Bumble has it, where it lets you choose what you want to do. Would you like to only do virtual dates? Would you like to meet? But with have you been vaccinated, etc. Which is great information. I mean, we can now register. Everybody over 18 can now register online and get the vaccine. Sooner you get the vaccine, you can start meeting other people who have gotten the vaccine.
Yeah.
So it has to be a collective effort, okay? Everybody's got to do this. No anti-vaxxers in this situation. And for girls, I mean, just be safe. Just be smart. If you are meeting somebody, like text 5 people about your location, their LinkedIn profile, their Instagram profile, their Facebook profile, their phone number, everything.
Okay. Do you guys have to take so many precautions?
Sometimes. I always do.
Yeah. Yeah. If you're going out in a cafe or something, then theek hai, samajh mein aata hai, people around, so kya hi hoga. But if you are going ahead and going to somebody's place, then going ahead. Sambhal ke. And I also want to say, just please be yourself, be your goofy self. Itna matlab, you know, you don't need to put shirtless pictures if you don't like them. You don't need to show off or anything. Just be yourself.
I mean, yeah. True.
I mean, I was more than happy to choose like this sweet musician boy in the clutter of gym boys and business people. So I think that is what a lot of us are looking for.
Musician, I don't know if musician boys are better than gym boys. I really do not know this.
I mean, it depends on what you are interested in. Artists.
I don't know. Just artists come with thoda sa baggage, na? Like,
that's I'm an artist. I understand, man. It's fine.
You have no baggage, Antariksh. You're just...
I have too much baggage, man.
Your pockets are empty. Nothing.
This entire episode was just me revealing all my baggage, guys.
No, I think that's I actually feel like there's a lot of like other stuff that we've not discussed here, but I think we scratched the surface thoda sa.
Yeah, cool. So a later episode we'll come back and revisit this.
Yeah,
cool. So Jalasmi, time to get back on the apps.
Yeah, maybe. That's what. Yeah. When a new wave of hope comes, I will definitely get back.
Okay, awesome. Thank you so much for joining me, guys. This is such a fun chat. I truly feel that I understand you guys a little bit more than I did just an hour before this. So thank you guys again. Jalasmi, Anna, where can people find you online? Jalasmi?
I have a private account, Baba, but yeah, I am on Hathi Ka Bachcha.
You are on Hathi Ka Bachcha? Are?
Yes, don't be on Hathi Ka Bachcha, man. Hathi Ka Bachcha.
My Instagram profile is Hathi Ka Bachcha.
Okay.
That's it.
That sounds like an insult. It's like you're insulting your Instagram profile. My Instagram profile is Kutta Kamina. It's Hathi Ka
Bachcha. Her surname is...
My surname is Hathi, Baba.
Yeah,
I know, but I'm just saying, dude. Take care. It sounds like an insult.
This is my Antrim.
I know. This happened to me. No, this happened to me once when I was Gmail pe pura na baata, right? So one of my, colleagues called me up. He's like, why are you calling us a Hathi? I'm like, arey, unka surname hai. Can't do anything about it.
Okay. Okay, awesome. You guys can follow Jalasmi and Hathi Ka Bachcha and Anna.
Whether you're an established sports person or a budding one, or simply a sports enthusiast,
you guys can follow me at AntarikshT on Instagram and AntarikshTag on Twitter.
Thank you
guys. See you guys next week.
Policy, bye-bye. Mindset and everything sport.
So tune in to the Millennial Athlete every Monday.
Only on the IVM Podcast Network.
Trust us, it's going to be lit.
How many times have you motivated yourself to improve your sleep or lose weight or be more productive? How many times have you failed? Hi, my name is Ashton Doctor. Tune into my show, The Habit Coach Podcast, where we focus on creating small, tiny habits to improve your life instead of those big, impossible tasks. So make listening to me a habit every Monday, Wednesday and Friday on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com or on your favorite podcasting app.